Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Best of Slot, and we are back playing Monster Loves You. We have just become an adult, we have 5% respect and lots of ferocity and bravery, just because that's how we roll. We can either pull a tick, like, spelled like politic, like a tick, with the monsters, or no, we're going to explore the whale mist. When we click on this, what does this do? Okay, I don't care about politics, we're going to explore. What do we want to do? There's a goat with 3 eyes. That's the best number of eyes for a goat. A squirrel hops into a pool of sunlight, bright-eyed and bushy-tailed, ready to bury nuts and make something of itself. You drop on it from a branch, grab it. Oh. A young wolf suddenly leaps in front of you, snaps the squirrel out of your claws and runs off, laughing and barking at the same time. That's impressive. I shall turn the tables on the wolf. A second squirrel creeps up and pokes at the discorporated head of the first one. You grab the new squirrel and chew on it a little, thinking. This is actually how I do most of my thinking. I chew on a squirrel. Lure the wolf closer with the squirrel. Yes, this is a plan. You dangle the squirrel over your maw, waiting. The wolf tries to steal it, as planned. You slash her with your claws and she flees, having learned not to mess with you again. Yeah, screw you, wolf. Don't know who you think you are. Sword! You find a red hood in a basket in the middle of a forest path. A human house is nearby. Funny, you never noticed it before. I shall circle you, pretty little house. There's a great deal of blood in the yard, along with a half-dead wolf coughing weakly. Kill it. You pin the wolf down. It coughs weakly. Then it dies. I shall take it home and eat it. I shall feast upon the wolf. You haul the strangely heavy carcass home. An elder points out a long, sewn-up gash down the wolf's belly and says it was good work. Thank you. I shall take credit for the woodcutter's surgical precision, for I have the surgical precision of a woodcutter. The elder's impressed. You open the gash and find stones inside the wolf. How odd. Lovely. It's going splendid. Look at all this respect. I have all of the respect. Snakes. Everyone loves snakes. Even snakes love snakes. You take the lead on a hunt in the whale mist, but you become separated from the group. Suddenly, you catch sight of something there. Where? Over there. Pay attention. Within that thicket. Rumour has it that an especially large, clever snake tricked Nash Nash, biting her and causing her to be sick for days, and it's right there, watching, waiting. Kill it! You slowly creep on upon it, sharpening your claws. Suddenly you stop. A print in the dirt is clearly from Nash Nash's foot, and that's definitely dried monster blood around it. I don't want to be a trap. Lure the crafty serpent into a trap so it can't bite you, sounds like plum. You perch on a branch above a crude snare and beat two rocks together to attract the snake's attention. This goes on for some time. Keep beating those rocks. Bum, 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 bum. No! Suddenly, the snake drops from a branch above you. You struggle, but it's too late. It crushes you with its tail. Look at the monster's face. It's so sad. Oh, that's heartbreaking. Everything getting dark. The next thing you know, Nash Nash has pounced on a snake. She grabs his head and holds his mouth shut, keeping his fangs trapped. Still crushing. Aww. God damn it, I lost respect. Nash Nash bit the head of the snake off and swallowed it. Nash Nash always swallows. This one! Wild chickens are back in season. As delicious as they are mean, chickens, they're loose within the whale mist and the haunters are all hunting them down. Get down there and hunt those wild chickens! Deep in the woods, you're looking for chicken scratch when you literally stumble over a hen. I suppose to metaphorically stumble over a hen guarding a cluster of chicks. The hen clucks and caws at you. Look at the hen, she's huge. Drive the weakest chickens away from the protector. Let's do that, let's be intelligent about this. Look at this, cleverness and ferocity and respect. Alright, I'm good at things, I like things. You chase avian beasts through the night and finally flush a passel of pullets into a village where Hamrak has a cookpot waiting. Oh, I did things, I like things. Blood, blood. Gallons of the stuff. You stalk the forest hunting an elusive swift elk. Suddenly it emerges from the underbrush, lowering its antlers and pawing at the ground. It's going to charge, kill it. The elk charges and you duck under it, smashing a hole in its chest. But instead of a heart you find nothing. The elk turns, catches you with its antlers and flings you into a tree. What the dot dot dot. The elk bounds away. It's unkillable. I shall return to Omen and warn the peoples. The others thank you for alerting them to this unusual prey. This spread out. Eventually, Jaggery finds the elk and devours it whole. He seems a little dizzy afterwards. Oh, Jaggery. Typical Jaggery. I expected respect for that. I've got my Frosty maxed out, so now I'm trying to get respect. You're bringing home a human coat you found hanging on a tree, where you see a cat waving you. I shall wave at the cat. Hello, Mr. Cat. How are you today? The cat is standing on its hind legs, wearing human boots, and indeed is covering a human clothing artifacts. Save me, he cries, pointing to a wolf who has a cornered. Get the wolf. Sure. More for fun than anything, you attack the wolf. You almost got him pinned when he stands up on his hind legs, flexes. What? What? What is the wolf doing? Get down. By the time you jump down, the wolf and the cat are gone. On returning, you tell the story. At least you got a tussle out of it. He's so happy. Look at his little cheeky grin. I swear, look at him. Why am I so little? Why have I not evolved into a thing? What's this? Is this home? Oh. Okay. Let's do some politicking. The spider. Today is the day of the Spinner 500, the big spider race. Yes. Butcher Spider hurt her. Oh no. Mrs. Penelope Eight Legs. What should you do? She's normally the fastest spider in the world, even the playing field. May the best spider win. Enter yours unaided. Yes, Penelope, you can do it. At a 13th entry, your spider comes in 14th when a beetle joins the race in a... Apparently I'm an honest and ferocious monster. I should do more politicking. That one. I should lift a rock. People love rock lifters. All of Portent Square is ours. Elders glare angrily at everyone, then look back at the sign at the Omen Town entrance. Broken, now. Look down at a little piece of the sign you're holding and blush. What? What did you do again? What have I done? Coming back from a hunt, you were so full of high spirits that you jumped up and slapped the sign. You just slapped a little too hard. With your claws. Happens all the time. I gave a high five to someone the other day and killed them. Awful. Awful stuff. What's that? That's a hand. I like hands. You show your newest collection of human artifacts to your neighbours. They seem suitably impressed and listen in. Say more! Exclamation mark. The truth is pretty boring, really. You just found them in the woods, but the gathered monsters seem so interested it should be ashamed to let them down. Monsters do love a story. Blybig! I tricked a human! You spin a wide web of clever lies showing how you took the artifacts right off the hands of a human, then tripped him with the stick as he chased you, and then he fell into a stream and was washed away. How did it give me respect? Respect. Yes! I'm a great liar. I lie with the best of them. I literally lie with them. Winky face. Sorry. Oh, I feel bad. A small pack of elder monsters are huddled at the edge of Omen, watching the woods and discussing something in hushed tones. I should listen in. Elder Hamrag is saying, this could simply be a rumor. Better what that was. We don't know they're out there for sure. What is going on, Elder Hamrag? Hamrag says, some of the younger monsters have seen others in the whale mist. Monsters from no town we know of. I'm actually doing hand actions while I do this. I can't help it. I can't do voices for hand actions. I can't do voices anyway, but I need the hand actions. Thin and cold. We've had food and shelter. Suggest everyone be on guard. Offer to host any homeless monster in your hovel. Everyone should be on guard. I lost respect and kindness. Greedblitz scoffs. That much is obvious, Dunderhead. Wait, this is what Greedblitz sound like. That much is obvious, Dunderhead. If we see strangers, we should drive them off or kill them. That really hurt my throat. The other elders don't seem so sure. I'm sorry. Oh, I know. My respect to points. Let's kill another snake. The snake moon is rising in the sky, and it's time to gather snakes for the ritual. I shall set out to gather snakes. But I'm a noble monster. You wander the fields and thickets nearest Omen. It's easy to catch the snakes, but every time you go after another, some of them squirm out of your grasp. Most of your snakes are getting away. I will dedication, I shall keep catching them alive. Huzzah! Everyone claps when you arrive with three living snakes clamped onto you by their fangs. The venom hardly stings at all. The snakes are added to the scaly cauldron along with a mass of other snakes. Some writhing, some writhing even, that would be the word, that's English. And others lying still. I shall join the ritual. The monsters gather around the cauldron. Proof Rock scrapes two sticks together to light a fire. It's gonna be a fun night. That's nice. I feel nice about this. This is nice. Slenderman! You hear Grit Mitten. That's an amazing name. I shall call my firstborn Grit Mitten. Telling younger monsters about the human that almost killed him. It's the pointy parts that get you, he says in a bizarre voice. Always wait until the knife is pointing somewhere else. Then, run away! He turns to you and says, isn't that right? I don't want to impress everyone, that's silly. Explain to the youngsters, human knife is always dangerous. calmly expand on Gritmidden's tale, sharing what you have learned about the frightening blades of the humans. The young monsters promise they will treat such things with respect, even if nobody's holding one. I'm very kind. I'm going in directions I never really intended. More politics! Let's do this chicken drumstick thing. Gobclaws and you are arguing about what to have for lunch. She got a pick last time. Gobclaw. Gobclaw, it's clearly my turn. Back off, bitch, alright? I need a name for my monster. Noah. Noah is the single greatest name ever. Noah. My monster is called Noah. Suddenly, Noah's favourite food flies down from the sky and... Suddenly, your favourite food flies down from the sky and perches within arm's reach. The magpie chirps.
How many of you seen the cornfield around here?
Your stomach growls, for the stomach is actually a monster in itself. Eat it! Eat the delicious monster!
What?
Fantastic amuse-bouche. Sadly, it wasn't much. You and Gobclaw still have to figure out what to have for lunch. Why did I lose respect for that? Come on! Gobclaw, again, shows off a human doll she found at the last hunt. A crowd of elders and other monsters gather around you, chattering excitedly. Indeed. She asks if you think it might be good to show the doll to some of the monsterlings. Let them see a human-shaped thing without actually seeing a real human, you know? Educational. That's a top answer. Gobclaws can see that you're bringing some science here. I'm laying down some science, yo. Laying down some serious science. Word. Science in this bizzle. They should know what a human looks like so they don't freeze up when they see one later. Gobclaws nods.
Good point.
We want the young ones to avoid humans, but not be so frightened they do anything foolish. I am intelligent. Gobclaws says, you're wiser than the rest of us. The rest of the monsters nod half-heartedly, but you can tell they appreciate your insight. Feel good, let's do another exploration. Let's go for this suspicious-looking little monsterling here. You scoop a big fish from the forest stream. As you're about to bite into it, it says... Wait, what does a fish sound like?
Wait!
And magic! I can grant you a wish! Sounds legit. I shall dispute the fish's spurious claim. I've had many fish lie to me before. I didn't mean to eat it. I didn't want to eat it. I just wanted it to back up its claim a little bit. God damn it. Monsters are gathering? Monsters are gathering around the skull pole. My words have left me. They invite you to dance with them. I shall dance. The only problem is you've never done the skull dance. And now, oh no. I shall wait for someone else to dance and I shall imitate them. They're all looking at you, right at you, expectantly. Noah can dance like a champion. I shall begin to dance. They shall respect my bravery. I shall try to show respect to the skulls. Hooray! You dance slowly and stumbly, not quite sure what to do, but you're doing it with dignity. When you finish, all the other monsters howl with approval. Full stop. One to go, guys, one to go. Oh no. Body begins to soften. This is actually what puberty is like for all men. So, women, if any females are watching this, just... I didn't read the whole thing before I said that. Your body begins to soften. Not quite puberty. It's dripping slime at the most inconvenient times. That's more like puberty. Elder monsters begin to look at you with understanding in their eyes. What's happening? You're growing old, my friend. You're not a spry monsterling anymore. I shall go and see the spine doctor. The doctor tells you that your time is almost up. You'll soon reach the end of adulthood and you will either ascend to elder status or dissolve into slime. What happens to those who dissolve? They let their bodies collapse into the spawning vat where their remains will nourish new generations of morsels. Now, oh god, that's not good. What happens to those who ascend? Those who are able to ascend will become elders and live on to dictate the future of monster kind. I shall go and prepare. A group of elders is waiting inside your hovel. It is time to dissolve or ascend. To the ceremony! The elders of Omen surround the spawning vat and you. Your body is already squishy and damp. They bring out a small cauldron. I should look at this cauldron you have here.
Oh, look at the face! It's so cute! It's adorbs. It's totes adorbs.
It's big enough to hold a little blood and slime for many monsters at once. It smells like iron and copper and herbs. The building's mulled fire underneath it.
Oh, it's so cute!
This is your last chance, you can stay or go. If you stay, it's time to take the test. Become an elder or to dissolve into the spawning vat. I shall stay and be tested! Oh god. When the elders see that you have accepted your fate, they all relax as well. Someone asks you if you want to ascend or if this is the end for you. I will ascend. I shall be an elder. A masked elder comes forward and stands before the iron cauldron. It's time to I need like an old voice.
It's time to decide whether you'll ascend to elderhood or dissolve the next generation. Watch.
She claws out her arm and holds it out. 3 drops of liquid spatter against the bottom of the empty cauldron. You can't tell for sure if it's blood or slime. The green elder asks, who has already chosen? I did that, I kind of did like a wavy. You know when you go to like a church in America and they'll go, praise Jesus! I kind of did that, I'm not really sure why. And some of the monsters approach the cauldron to add their own fluids to the collect. This is creepy. The liquid begins to tremble. The nameless elder has placed 5 small, flat stones on the ground before you, she says. Choose one. Chance will guide your claw. I shall pick up an attractive stone. The other side of the stone is etched with a crude glyph. It shows one monster kneeling beside another. Injured monster. The green elder says, we will test your kindness. My kindness is rubbish. Don't test my kindness. A huge elder carries another monster close to the cauldron. The other monster is half melted. Oh, poor Mr. Monster. It's Nash Nash. Nash Nash, no. Oh, no, not Nash Nash. She's begun to dissolve, like you. And her condition is far advanced. What's going to happen to her? Not Nash Nash. The green elder says, we have decided that Nash Nash is too violent. There is a place for pure ferocity in our world, but it must be tempered. I keep doing the hand wave thing, I can't help it, I'm a handsy person. But it must be tempered with other qualities. I have no idea what my housemates think I'm going to be doing. Regard your own soft, wobbly claws. The elder says, see her eyes? See her eyes? They still seethes. She still seethes with pure rage. The fact is, you can calm her before the end. I shall risk my life to save Nash Nash. You look down at Nash Nash and realize you could tear out your own heart and use it to restore life to her body. It's insane, but it might work. Of course, you're likely to die too. 50% chance of survival? Do it! But you shove your own heart into Nash Nash's body. It touches a little bit of hers that's still intact. Lub dub. Lub dub. Lub dub 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 dub. You've done it! Nash Nash rises. Now solid enough to walk and think. Even a green elder is speechless. I shall encourage you to apologize, Nash Nash. At your prompting, the revived Nash Nash issues a halting apology to the elders. They agree to revisit her case before she dissolves. I shall approach the cauldron unsteadily. Yes! You hold the cauldron. It's heavy. Let us look inside this cauldron. It's half blood and half slime. At least some of the elders support you. I don't know what that means. I shall drink the portentous infusion. The best type of infusion. Yes! Yes! Champion! You drink the bubbling concoction, then belch. And howl! That's how one howls as a monster. Your body solidifies almost instantly. You are an elder now. Cool beans. Unseen text. Pretty sure that's not meant to be there. Getting respect up, getting respect up. Remember, brave and ferocious. You are now an elder and reside in Snack, a bustling city at the center of the monster world. In this stage of life, if you play your cards right, you'll be able to affect both the way monsters and few humans and vice versa. Use your powers of persuasion wisely. Awesome! I'm an elder! Where am I? I don't see myself. Am I one of these? Maybe I have evolved now. Am I one of these things? Oh no, no, there I am! I'm that tiny little blob there! Why am I not evolving? Why am I still the smallest little useless thing on the planet? This is how well monsters think of humans. Okay, there's a conflict on the way. Oh no, I'm gonna have to be intelligent. That's where we're gonna end it. Thank you very much for joining me as always, ladies and gentlemen. Please do like, comment, subscribe if you're enjoying this little let's play, and stick around for lots more let's plays. Not necessarily like this, but lots more let's plays, and we're doing lots of exciting things lately. And that tire in the right corner has an eye in it. That's intriguing. Thanks for joining me, guys. Much love as always. Please do like, comment, subscribe. We'll see you next video. Cheers. Much love. Bye bye.